Hello, so we're here in Ubud with Henry Manambiring, the author of Philosophy Teras. It's a book that talks about the philosophy of Stoicism and that has resonated with so many people because, you know, I think we all relate with the same struggles that you did as an executive at the fast-paced advertising industry.
I'm torn between a great murder mystery by Agatha Christie, but probably I will take Letters from a Stoic by Seneca.
Uh-huh.
Just for the reason I'm stuck in a library, so I just feel
the murder
that
mystery might be scary.
Might be scary. Doesn't offer much consolation. While reading Letters from Seneca, it was written almost 2,000 years ago, I think, and it talks a lot about life being unfortunate, you know, how to deal with adversity, how to deal with difficult times. So I just think that it's fitting. Very recommended. It is a collection of letters from Seneca. He was a philosopher, but also a tutor to Nero, the Roman emperor. And the letters covered broad range of subjects, you know, from friendship, from illness, from dealing with wealth. It's amazing. It's just an amazing collection of thoughts. It's actually concurrent.
Okay.
I mean, because I was reading one of the books on Stoicism, and then it was down the rabbit hole for me. Like I just couldn't stop because I found the philosophy very relevant, very helpful personally. So from contemporary books, so basically modern books written on the subject, I moved to the original text. Okay, the real original text. And initially I was afraid that I thought, a 2,000 year old writing must be boring, must be irrelevant, I cannot relate. To my surprise, it wasn't the case. Seriously, I mean, if you read the writings of the ancient Stoics, it is as if they are all written by someone living today. I guarantee you. So people realizing that they are at the mercy of fortune, and back in the days, they have different problems. Like for example, political instability. It was terrible time because it's not non-democratic society, obviously, right? Emperor, it is an empire led by emperor, and sometimes emperor acted on a whim, right? Or there is a change of power that happened on a sudden, which is very typical. One ruler was assassinated by another ruler within a few days, got replaced again. Actually, in some modern countries, it also happened that way, right? With the election. So a lot of uncertainty, a lot of fear. War and famine, things repeat themselves. Yes, we now enjoy technology, smartphone, internet, which those people didn't have. But the negative emotion are pretty much the same. Either way, I mean, for Indonesians, if they are too afraid to read, like, look, the thing with original text is, to be honest, the translation to Bahasa Indonesia is not very good.
Oh.
The very reason why I write Philosophy Teras is because it was written in native tongue, you know, from the beginning.
Easy.
So it's
accessible.
Much easier rather than reading a translation. But for those whose English is very proficient, I would recommend go straight to the original text, man. Even better, skip my book. go straight to the source. Last one modern book that I was excited about, that I really rave. Okay, there are two books. I would recommend Range by David Epstein. Range is very good. Range talks about how people with general skill or generalists will probably thrive better than the specialist. We were raised thinking that focus on one field,
be
very good at it, right?
Yeah.
And then you excel at it, and then you'll be successful.
Yeah.
So this book is a bit counterintuitive because it says no. Actually, based on, you know, I mean, robust data, like a lot of interview, a lot of study. Epstein said that those who are generalists will be more versatile. And exactly because life changed so fast, being a specialist can be a handicap because you are too grounded to a certain domain. I think another book that I recommend, the title is Quit.
Quit.
Quit. Very interesting. Very, very good. And it just changed my mind, you know.
Wow.
So it's more balanced now. Of course, we worship people who show perseverance. But if you are wise, there are times where the universe is telling you, come on, man.
This is not
maybe
the right
this
direction.
Is not the right thing. And keep banging on is actually costing you. Yeah, it's actually costing you time, your family time, your energy, or your sanity. And then this book came along. No, actually, sometimes the smart ones know when to give up, when to quit. Oh my God! I know. Lisbeth Salander from The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo.
Yeah. Oh my God, that would be so much fun.
Such a strong character.
Yes.
Strong heroine. The way what's the writer's name? Stieg Larsson.
Stieg Larsson, yes.
The way Stieg Larsson portrayed the character, I've never seen the character that came to life vividly in my mind. Like, I want to meet this girl. And she's not pleasant, right? She's a hacker. She's quiet, antisocial. Amazing, amazing character. I've been fascinated with strong women, and you know, I wish more Indonesia have more strong women. My guilty pleasure when I was in college is Robert Ludlum's books, the Bourne trilogy. I love the world. Jason Bourne
seems exciting.
Yeah, spy and everything. I think another series that I enjoy would be Robert Langdon, Da Vinci Code.
Yeah.
I love the character and I love the world. Maybe this is too cliche, but I would love to meet Marcus Aurelius, I guess, who authored Meditation. And actually, one question I have is actually not very deep. It's a question, how do you feel knowing that your supposedly secret journal is now out in the open and millions of people read it? I mean, are you pissed? He was writing for himself, but now it becomes the book of millions, so I want to know how he feels. But I think I know his answer. If he's being very stoic about it, he would just say, I can't control it. I'm happy if it helps people.
Thank you so much. This
thank
has been
you,
a really fun conversation.
Likewise, thank you for having me.
Thank you.